Thanks so much for speaking with us, Bill, and about your film, The Skeleton Twins.
No problem.
A lot of people are commenting on how this is one of your first dramatic roles. Do you see this as a turning point in your work?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I always just approach it by, you know, you read something and you connect to it and say, well, that'd be, I'll throw my hat in the ring for that and hopefully they'll hire me, you know, and I was excited that they did. It was also my first lead role, you know, and that's the biggest role I've ever had in a movie. So those two things put together, I mean, it was a very exciting project, and I had been attached to it for 2 years before we shot. So 3 years now. It was like I met Craig 3 years ago to talk about the movie, and for 2 years before they got the financing, it was basically just emailing each other every month. How's it going? Any new news? How's it going? You know, so it's happy that it worked out.
Right. So this has been like a passion project for a while. Then,
yeah,
for
yeah. Yeah. Long time. Yeah.
Wow. So we have to talk about that epic lip sync scene.
Yeah.
Nothing's going to stop us now. Did you and Kristen do a lot of takes or rehearse that?
We would have shot that for days. We had such a good time. It was in the script and it was just a small little description in the script. And then we went out and we rehearsed it with Craig, and I had a bunch of ideas, and Kristen had some ideas, and Craig had ideas, so it was just really the three of us working it out, and then the cinematographer had some ideas, you know, I could shoot this angle, and and so it was a big collaborative thing, you know, but it was what's good about it, it's very emotional, it's him trying to, she's in a funk, and he knows how to get her out of the funk.
And in real life, you said that you used to lip sync with your younger sisters.
Yeah, I have two younger sisters, and that when I read that in the script, I went, my gosh, that is exactly the kind of stuff we used to do, where we would just listen to, you know, whatever my mom's albums
were.
What
would you lip sync to?
That was a good question. Oh, I mean, all the 80s hits, you know, we would just, like, run around and sing probably to like songs. I mean, that is the perfect song for it, that Jeff and the Starship song. You know, also is a Mannequin, which was a movie that was on TV a lot when we were growing up, so we watched that a lot. So, yeah, I mean, I was really, you know, when I read that, I just thought, oh, wow, I know exactly what to do in this scene. I'm so excited to do it. You know?
So in the film, you and Kristen are siblings that are estranged. Did your real-life sibling relationships at all inform some of that?
Not really. No. I mean, no. Not really. I mean, I think it's just, you know, I think the Kristen and I have kind of a sibling relationship just because we've known each other for so long. And so that's the kind of thing you can't really fake, you know. Mm-hmm. It's a thing that, it's a chemistry and just a bond that you have with someone that you can't, you know, you can't manufacture that. So Craig was smart in a way where he would stand off and let, like, especially in the scene where we're on nitrous and we're in the dentist office. He just was like, you guys just, you know, do your thing,
right.
You know. And even in this, you know, me, I like one scene, I love how it comes out, and I feel like the real bond between us is that scene where I tell her in the dentist's office that I've been with a woman.
Mm-hmm.
I just love that scene, just the way we're playing off each other, and it's just so effortless. And I just, when I watch that scene, I'm like, oh, there's no way, that is Kristen and I. It's just like, that's talking, you know, just, but you get into a, yeah, very comfortable with each other, you know.
Right. And your character, Milo, is gay. It seems like it would be easy for some people, but reductive, to compare him to your other character that you're known for, Stefan.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But how is playing Milo a completely new character for you, who just by coincidence happens to be gay?
Yeah, I think Craig said it in a good way. You know, the only thing that's similar between Stefan and Milo is that they're both gay. I mean, they're two totally different people. I mean, so, but I never approached it that way. I mean, the fact that he was gay was just part of his personality, but it didn't define him in any way, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Just, that's part of the personality, and you play it that way. And I was very conscious of, you know, Craig Johnson, the director, is gay, and I was very conscious of making it not the straight guy playing the gay part. I was like, please tell me, it's got to be, you know, authentic. I don't want to get too fabulous, you know, at times. But when I was in drag for the Halloween sequence that day, when I showed up, he was like, "Be as fabulous as you want today. You've earned it."
Great direction. Yeah. As fabulous as you
just
want.
Just be fabulous today, Bill. And I was like, all right.